Hello and welcome to fourth part of my FPS tutorial series where I'll be creating gun mechanics similar to those in my own game, Raise Your Pride. In this episode we will cover hands way. If you haven't watched the previous parts, please go watch those. If you're a fan of multiplayer survival games, you can wishlist my game on Steam, link in description. I would be really glad. Also, feel free to leave any comments you like and give ideas to topics on which I should create the tutorials. Okay, let's dive into this tutorial. First, we need to make new function to player interface. Find your player interface that you create in last part. You find it also here. Let's make a new function. Press add and add function. You can call it anything you like. For example, get handsway floats. Then we need three outputs type of float. So all directions we can sway our weapon. First going to be sight movement. Second going to be mouse X. And the last one going to be mouse Y. Then you can compile and save and code back your third person character blueprint and begin play. This is what we are going to do next. You could also do in event tick, but event tick is usually not a good way to do things in blueprint because of performance. So I can show you how to use event timers. Probably this you should do in event tick, but educational purposes I show this way. So create set timer by event and create new custom event, call it anything you like. Then you can adjust time to be something like 10 in this example. So this will be executed after 10 seconds, but we don't want that. Set it looping and now adjust time to be really low value, something about 0.015. For example, so it acts like event tick. Then compile and save and open up your interface function. In here we want to promote these variables. So promote the variable. Do not press that promote the local variable. We don't want those be local. Local variables can be used outside of this function, and we don't want that. You can also put these variables to own category. It is usually a good way to do things. Then compile and save and go back to your begin play. In here, custom event, we want to actually set those variables. Connect pins. And now sight movement. We want to get that in enchanted input action function. You can find it here. It's this one. And then we want to split that structure. Right click and split. We want to use that X value to sight movement. And then we want to get mouse X. Search it here. And then mouse Y. And then you can just connect those pins. After that, we are ready here. So compile and save and open up your animation blueprint. Here we need to call that function. So get character. You could also use try to get pawn owner, and probably it's better the way do it, but we have been using that character variable that is created in here. So call that function. Now you can collapse this the function to be more organized. You can name it, for example, F handsway. Then just double click it and open it. Now you want to search map range clamp node. It is same as multiplying it by some value. Then we need a rotator value, sorry, variable. Create new variable and call it, for example, hand sway rotator. And set its type to be rotator also. Now you can drag and drop it here, and then you can split it. Now set those floats -1 to 1 and -10 to 10. This is basically the same thing if you multiply that side movement value by 10, but we are going to use that map range clamp node. And then find F interrupt 2. Drag that current to be target, and then we need to get that Y pitch to current. Then set interrupt speed to be 5. You can adjust that how you like. And then get delta seconds to be delta time. Now we have to copy and paste these 2 times for the mouse X and mouse Y. Then set 1 to -1 in this. Now you can just connect these values. This can be a little bit confusing, but you will understand later on when you see how it works. Remember to switch those. Now get that hand sway rotator and set it. You can also split it here. And then connect correct values to correct places. This is Y, connect Y. And this is X, connect to X. But this is Z, connect to Z. Make sure everything is similar. You can also comment this if you like. To more organized. It is a good way to do blueprints. Then compile and save. Now we are ready here. So go to your anim graph. Make a little bit room here beginning and find modify bone node that we used before. Then we don't need translation. You can expose pin set off and also scale and alpha. But that rotator pin we need. Set it to add to existing. Then bone, select your right hand. Then you can copy paste it one time and connect pins, and then set this to be left hand. Now get that hand sway rotator variable and connect it to rotation, like this. And now I think we are ready here. Compile and save, and you can try it out. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and stay tuned for next part where we start making firing projectiles and procedural recoil. See you in next video. Bye!